Kia ora, good evening. Just over a day to go and Nationals heading for a shock loss in the Northland by-election. That's according to our last ONE News Colmar Brunton poll before the vote.
It shows Winston Peters way out in front, thanks largely to support from Labor voters. Political editor Corin Dan is following the campaign trail in Northland and joins us now live from Kerikeri. So, Corin, is this panic stations for National?
Oh, yes, it is. They know they're behind. They know they're in trouble. That's why John Key has come here today and tomorrow to try and turn this around, to try and use his political skills, his political clout. But even with all that on tonight's poll, it's going to be very hard for him to stop the Winston Peters juggernaut.
National's prized weapon rushed back to Northland today. What's now become a desperate last-minute campaign rescue mission.
Absolutely, National has every chance of winning the seat. It's absolutely crucial, ultimately, that our voters turn out.
Winston Peters, however, streaking ahead in our ONE News Colmar Brunton by-election poll. He has 53% support. National's Mark Osborne, 17 points behind him on 36%. Labor's Willow Jean Prime on 9%.
They can't just change the course of history here by supporting us. They have to get out and vote.
And a big part of this result can be put down to Labor leader Andrew Little's signal to Labor voters that they should back Mr. Peters. Willow Jean Prime's vote has more than halved since that signal. And Labor voters are heeding Andrew Little's call, with nearly 70% saying they'll back Mr. Peters.
I'm just being realistic. We weren't going to win it, and it's quite clear that we're going to come a distant third.
Mark Osborne's remaining upbeat despite the poll.
We're getting a really, really good response out there, so absolutely we can win this.
But the worry for him is 15% of his National voters say they'll vote for Mr. Peters on Saturday. Nationals rolled out some big election sweeteners in this campaign, so we asked, do you think the National Party promised 10 new bridges and extended ultra-fast broadband in Northland because they are worried they may lose? 71% said yes.
They plucked them out of mid-air. And now they've been caught by the people around them saying, you did no work on this.
If people say, well, you're discussing those because there's a by-election on, that's true, but that's because we're doing that to make sure that people understand what our program would be.
So one full day to go and a desperate John Key under pressure to avoid what could be his first significant electoral loss as Prime Minister.
If they lose, it's not going to bring down the government, Corin. So explain what's really at stake here, why National's so desperate not to lose.
Well, you're right, it won't bring down the government, but it is a handbrake on their agenda, what they can do. If Winston Peters wins, it's one more to the opposition, and it means National has to negotiate more with those minor parties on legislation like the Resource Management Act. So for people who want to see big changes to that act, this really does matter. Now, Winston Peters today was trying to counter that, saying, well, almost offering an olive branch, that he too might look at talking with National about that act. But look, there's also the psychological impact of a loss here. This is a safe National seat. They had a 9,000 strong majority. To lose this when they've got 49% popularity across the country, could that be a tipping point and a big psychological blow to National? That's what they're worried about, and that's why they'll go very hard tomorrow.
All right, thanks very much. Political editor Corin Dan.